sure if Marie is coming up, but she'll come on when she gets there. So go ahead and sit back on your heels. Allow your hips to sink back towards your heels. Allow your belly to soften in between your thighs. Allow your mind to be still. So bring your focus and attention to your breath. And so let the breath kind of be the distraction for the distractions. So when your mind starts to wander, and it will, most likely, just bring it back to your breath. So your arms could be anywhere right now. They could be under your head, in between your legs, by your side, under onto a block, whatever feels soothing to you for the next few breaths. And really start to lengthen your breaths, start to fill them up, make them soft yet powerful. And when you're ready, just begin to extend your arms out in front of you a little bit more, if they're not already. And as you get there into this space, just settle in a little bit more. Find a little bit more space from fingertip to toe tip, from fingertip to heel to tailbone. Fill up completely with prana, energy, chi. Take a breath in and lift your head and chest up as you walk to the right side. Bring your left hand on top of your right. Stretch it a little bit longer. Reach on your fingertips to your heels. And breathe under the left side of your body. Yes, Maria. One more breath. Hi, Maria. When you get there, just mute yourself and say hi later. Inhale through center. Exhale up and over to the other side. Moments to find some stillness, some softness, as we prepare our body for some more movement and perhaps challenge. Inhale back to your center. Walk your hands back to your knees. Bring your knees together. Perhaps you might want to sit on a block or anything else if you have it. And just bring your fingertips next to your thighs. Drop your shoulders down, lift your heart up. Walk your fingertips away out to the side so you're resting right on your fingers. And inhale your left arm up as you move to the right side. Keep your hips connected to your heels, and then maybe use your arm to give you a little bit more opening here. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Inhale, rise up, left hand down, right arm comes up and over. Keep your right heel connected to your hip or hip connected to your heel. Reach up, find that long, long stretch. Come back to center, inhale, bring your right hand behind you, left arm outside your thigh. Look over your right shoulder, drop both shoulders down towards the earth. Draw your ribs down towards your hips and belly towards your spine. Inhale your right arm up as you lean over to the left side. Exhale, cross the arms in front of you, lift your chest. Exhale, open the arms over your head. Release the hands behind your back, fingers pointing in whichever direction is okay for you, and just stretch the front of your shoulder chest if you have your fingers pointing forward. One more big breath. And then exhale, come to sit on your heels, interlace your fingers behind your back, knuckles towards the earth as you open your chest again, and then tuck your chin to your chest, forehead to your knee, crown of the head to the floor, lift off your heels, come into a rabbit pose with your arms interlaced behind your head or behind your back. Try to put no weight onto your head, but let your weight rest in your top of your foot and shin. One more breath here. And as you empty the breath, go ahead and sit back on your heels, release the knuckles to the earth. And then keep your left arm behind you as you take your right arm outside your left thigh. Lengthen your spine, inhale. Twist a little deeper as you exhale. And then take your left arm up and over to the right side, just leaning, just enough to feel the stretch down the left side of the body, however much you can get. Exhale, the hands cross over at the wrists or the forearms. Inhale, stretch the arms all the way up and interlace your fingers, one finger over from the last grip. Hi, Maria. Heart opens, knuckles down, lift your chest. And exhale, fold over your legs, lift your hips from your heels. No weight in the head, just in the top of the foot and shin. Inhaling, exhaling as you sit back on your heels. Knuckles to the earth, lift your chest. And then release your arms overhead, take a breath. Exhale, stretch your arms back out for child's pose, just pushing your hips one more time to your heels. And then inhale onto your hands and knees, and take your legs and stretch them out behind you, just release some tension from the knees. Come back to your center, tabletop position, hands under shoulders, knees under hips. Arch your back, dip your belly, broaden your collarbones. Exhale, tuck the tailbone, chin to chest, head comes down. Think about putting your hamstrings on your sitting bone, or your sitting bones on your hamstrings. And then inhale, arch your back, tuck your toes under, stretch the bottoms of your feet, broaden your collarbones. Exhale, round and curl, top of the foot, shin down on the floor, press the floor down with your hands and spread your upper shoulders apart. Inhale, arch your back, dip your belly, tuck your toes one more time. This time let's come to a neutral position and bring your hands, your right foot in between your two hands. And so maybe if you have blocks and you want to use blocks, you put your hands on blocks. Bring your shoulders back and your collarbones forward. And just check out the alignment, knee over the ankle and the back leg. Make sure you're not sitting directly on top of your knee so you come a little bit above it. Good, take a breath. And then inhale, straighten your front leg, fold over it. Now it's kind of early. Some of us have really tight hamstrings, so again, put your hands on blocks, bend your knee, shift yourself so that your hips are a little bit more squared. Don't worry about straightening the leg all the way, ever. Another breath. Inhale, re-bend the front knee. Take your hands on top of your thigh and just press the flesh forward. So just think about smoothing the flesh from the hip to the knee. On the inhale, let's bring the arms all the way overhead. Grab a hold of your left wrist and lean to the right. Keep pressing the left hip forward. Keep pressing the left foot with the shin down. Inhale, back to center and just switch sides. Nice little stretch over the right, from the right side. Inhale, back to center. Release the hands to the floor. Tuck your back toes underneath you. Lift the knee up and just step into a downward facing dog. From here, hips up in the air. Lift up onto your tippy toes. Shift your weight back to your heels and chest towards your thighs. And then walk your dog from side to side, right, left, knee bends. Put a little more pressure from the right hand and the left hand and the right foot. Just, you know, kind of moving your body front and back, side to side. And then when you're ready to settle, settle. Big breath into, stretch out the back side of your body. And on the next inhaling breath, rise high up on your tippy toes, look forward and come to a high plank. Looking towards the front of your mat, push the earth away, your body is parallel to the floor. Good, let your knees rest down on the floor and let your belly come all the way down to the floor. Move your hands so they're right in line with your first ribs or your bra line, elbows squeeze in by your side. Lift your chest up without using your hands. Keep your eye gaze steady, maybe front of the mat, a little bit in front of that. Exhale, come on down to the floor. Inhale, once again, lifting without using your hands, so lift your hands up off the floor. Squeeze your elbows in, lengthen your spine from tailbone to top of the head. Empty it out, come down one more time. This time, lift your arms up again and keep the top of your foot down, but lift your thighs up. So engage your quadricep muscles, big muscles of the thigh. Squeeze your elbows in and in, lift up. And as you exhale, lower down to the floor, sit on your heels, tuck your toes underneath you. And as you come forward, step your left foot in between your two hands. So help it out if you need to. Come to your fingertips or blocks. Pull your shoulders back and down, lift your heart up. And just settle into this. Just check out the alignment, knee over the ankle. You're not sitting on top of your back knee. And you keep broadening through your collarbones. Take another breath here. Good. Inhale, stretch the front leg as straight as it'll go. Again, the blocks are always very useful here, and they have three heights, so you can adjust it any which way you need to if your hamstrings are tight.
like mine. Fold over left leg. Inhale. And exhale. This breath takes us back to our bent knee. Place your hands on top of your thigh. Good. Keep pressing so that you're kind of taking your flesh from your hip all the way through the top of the knee. And then that brings us to a little bit of a back extension. Take the arms up overhead, inhaling. Take your left wrist to your, or hold on to your right wrist and lean over to the left side. Boy, I'm getting my sides mixed up, huh? Inhale back to center and just switch sides. That's easier to say. Inhale back to your center, lift your heart. Release your hands to the floor or blocks. Exhale, tuck your right toes underneath you, lift the knee up, and go ahead and step back, downward facing dog. Hips come up in the air. And then, you know, do what you did before. Play it out, walk it out. Just make sure you're not putting too much weight into the front of your body or your wrists, your shoulders, your neck. Inhale high on your toes, make everything nice and strong. And come forward to a high plank. Look forward towards the front edge of your mat. Crown of the head, tailbone, one long line. Now shift just a little forward here. Either go to your knees or go halfway down. Roll over your toes. Upward facing dog, you can be on your belly for cobra. Thighs are very active. And downward facing dog, we are back up into. And breathe. Inhale and exhale. Good, rise up onto your tippy toes, soften your knees, look at the front of your mat and make your way there. Take your time, keep your blocks nearby should you want to use them. Fold over your body and let it go. Let's take a hold of opposite elbows and sway a little side to side. Feel the weight in the big toe, ball of the foot, pinky toe, heel of the foot. When you're ready, just switch the cross of your arms. Just feels a little different. And then settle into the center. Let your head come down towards the floor. You're sitting on top towards the sky. And then empty and let go of the arms dangle. Tuck your chin to your chest, push down through your feet and come up slowly.
As you come up, roll the shoulders back and around. Good. Stretch the arms overhead, inhale. Take a hold of the left wrist, lean to the right side. Same thing we did on our knee. Come back to center, switch to the other side, exhale. One more time, come back to center, take it to the right, hold for a few moments. Try to find the maximum length through the side of the body. Lift up like you're coming over a ball and you're just kind of folding yourself there. And then open your throat and heart, one more breath. Inhale to center, switch sides. Lift up and over. And then settle for a bit. Look over or under your right elbow. Breathe in, find a little bit more space if you'd like. Come back to center, inhale. Exhale, release the arms, put the hands on your back, fingers in either direction, squeeze the elbows in, and lift your heart up. Eye gaze to the sky. So now that ball has come under your upper back, and that's where we fold. Inhale your way back up, lead with your heart. And take it all the way down to the floor. Hands on floor, shins, or your blocks. Halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bring your right foot to the back of the mat. Lower your back knee to the floor. Inhale, your arms reach up overhead. Grab a hold of your left wrist. Lean to your left side. Good. Inhale to center. Exhale, hands to the floor. Straighten your front leg just for the breath. When you exhale, re-bend the leg. Tuck your right toes underneath you and turn a quarter turn to your right side. So you're facing the long side of your mat, right side of your mat. Doesn't matter if you're facing me or not. Take a block with you should you need it. Lengthen your spine, inhale. Exhale, fold your body in half. Let your head come down towards the floor. Soften your knees. Your head doesn't have to touch the floor, but it's very close. If it's very close, shorten your stance. Inhale, come to your fingertips, lengthen your spine. Now, all together, put your hands on your hips, lengthen and come up to standing. So if you did shorten your stance a lot, you might want to widen it because we're taking it into Warrior Two as you turn your right toes to the right. Bend your right knee, reach the arms out side to side, gazing over your right middle finger. Pull back with your left hand. Breathe in, and we'll pump it three times. Arms and legs straight. Exhale, come down through center. Inhale, arms and legs straight. Exhale, come down through center. Inhale, arms and legs straight. And this time we're going to hold warrior two with our right leg bent. Breathe in. Breathe out. Keep reaching in two directions, reaching front and back, drawing from your navel point. One more breath. Inhale. Now, as you exhale, come back to the front of your mat. Bring the right hand down on the floor or block. Left hand opens up. We twist. Hug your hips in towards midline. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Inhale, left hand comes down. Exhale, left foot steps back. Take a vinyasa. Skip it. Add to it. You do you. We all meet in downward facing dog. Hips up in the air. Inhale. Left leg high in the sky. Exhale, left leg steps through. Inhale, right leg meets. Exhale, fold. Now inhale your way to stand. Bring it all the way up. Bring your hands to your heart center. As you exhale, release your arms by your side. Inhale, arms up overhead. Fold your way to the floor. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, left leg steps back. Left knee comes to the earth. Inhale, arms reach up. Lean to your right side. Grab a hold of your left wrist. Good. Nice long stretch. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, arms down. Straighten your front leg. Just sit back. Just for the breath. Inhale, re-bend. Tuck your left toes underneath you. Lift the knee up. Turn a quarter. Turn to your left side. Lengthen your spine. Inhale. So we're just facing the opposite side that we faced before. Hang your head down. Inhale and exhale, trying to find a nice long stretch in between the two legs. Anybody who wants to go flying can go flying. You'll have multiple opportunities here, though. Inhale, come on up halfway. Hands to your hips, long spine. Inhale all the way up. Turn your left toes to the back of your mat, arms out. Bend your left knee, warrior two, left leg. Three pumping warriors. Inhale, arms and legs straighten. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, arms and legs straighten. Exhale, come back down. One more time, arms and legs straighten. Exhale, hold your warrior two, not your breath, just your pose. Reaching back with your right arm, forward with your left arm. Bend your knees, looking good, gang. Inhale. And exhale, settle a little deeper. One more breath, inhale. Exhale, now inhale, sweep yourself back to the front of your mat. Left arm down, right arm up, twist. You can always lower the back knee to the floor. Reach your hand up and down in opposition. Find more length in the spine as you rotate. And then as you exhale, right hand comes down. Right leg steps back to a high plank and flow through your sequence with or without chaturangas, or maybe adding chaturangas. Downward dog is where we meet. Chest towards your thighs. Lift your right leg in the air nice and high. Inhale, step it through. Exhale. Inhale, left leg meets top of the mat. Exhale, fold your body in half. And then rise on the inhale, hands to prayer as you exhale. And then come on back to center. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold through center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, right foot steps back. Now you can choose to bring your knee onto the floor or not. You can bring your hands onto your thigh, or you can bring your arms all the way overhead. Bend the back knee a little bit, tuck your tailbone under, grab a hold of your right wrist, and lift up and over to your left side. Inhale. Beautiful. Exhale. Come back to center. Inhale. Hands to floor or blocks. As you exhale, straighten your front leg. Pull the left hip back and the right hip forward. Inhale, lengthen your spine. And exhale, quarter turn to your right side. So we're back on the right side of your mat. Fold your body in half. Inhale, hands to hips. Rise up to standing. Exhale, tuck your tailbone under. Arms up, inhale is right leg. Your right leg spins out, warrior two. Let's just do one pump here. Arms up. And
And exhale, warrior two, hold them, hold your breath. Inhale. And exhale. Now inhale, drop your left arm to your left leg, right arm comes up. Don't change the front leg. Keep your knee bent. Lift up and out of your waistline. Reaching back to the side, or side and back. Nice stretch on the right side of the body. Stay with your front leg as it is. Inhale to warrior two as you exhale, settle. And then inhale, wing up front, right arm down, left arm up is your twist. There you go, breathe in. Exhale, the left hand down, step back through high plank. Exhale through low plank, inward, upward. Inward facing dog and downward facing dog, breathe in. Good, inhale, high on your toes, soften your knees, look at your front of your mat. Make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, and inhale, ride your breath to standing. Bring your arms up, and bring your hands to your heart center. Exhale, arms by your side. Inhale, arms all the way up. Exhale, fold through center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, left leg steps back. You can take your knee to the floor. You can have your hands on blocks, hands on your thighs, or bring your arms up. As you exhale, send your back knee towards the floor. And go ahead and grab that left wrist and stretch over to the right side. Inhaling. And exhale. Now feel free to keep the knee bent or straighten it out. One more breath. Hug hips towards midline. Inhale back to center. As you exhale, hands on floor or blocks. And straighten your front leg. Pull the right hip back and left hip forward and just fold. You can lift your toes or not. Your choice. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Take a breath. Inhale. Walk over to your left side. Quarter turn. You might even be slightly pigeoned for this placement. Inhale, halfway lift, hands to hips. Rise up to standing. Arms open out to the side. Exhale, left knee bends, warrior two. One pump, arms up and legs straighten. Exhale, warrior two. Pull back with your right arm, pull forward with your left. Keep your left leg as it is and take the right arm down, left arm up. Don't change the position of your front leg. Whoops. Inhale back to warrior two. Exhale, windmill to the front, left arm down, right arm up, twist. Looking for space from crown of the head to tailbone. Exhale, right hand down, step back to plank. You choose how you want to make it to downward facing dog. It's your day, it's your mat, it's your piece of property that you're on. You choose how you want. Inhale, high on your toes, soften your knees. Take a step or jump to the top of your mat, halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, rise to stand, bring your arms with you overhead. Exhale, bring your heart to your hand to your heart center. Arms by your side. Good, we're gonna add on a little bit, so take your arms overhead. As you exhale, fold down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, right foot steps back. Inhale, arms come up, you choose. Maybe you want the knee still on the floor. Bend your knee and then straighten it if you can. Come back to center on the inhale. Exhale, hands to the floor, straighten your front leg. Inhale, lengthen and turn to your right side. Keep your legs wide, inhale. Halfway lift, hands to your hips or heart now. Come up to standing. Tuck your tailbone underneath you, right toes to the right, warrior two. Exhale. Inhale, pump that warrior. And then come back to warrior two as you exhale. Now inhale, left arm down, right arm up, and the right leg stays the same. Inhale back to warrior two, exhale. And now straighten your front leg. Maybe shorten your stance in the back foot and reach your hips to the left as your torso goes to the right for triangle pose. Right arm down, left arm up. Legs are square, shoulders are stacked. Imagine that you are leaning your entire backside body against a wall. And perhaps you have one and you can do that. So think about not collapsing the bottom side of your body, right? So I'll turn this way a little bit. I might slip on my floor. But you want to lift this bottom side of your body up and in as you create five triangles in your body. Okay. One more breath. Good. Coming up from your triangle pose, inhale, re-bend your front knee as you exhale, warrior two. And then inhale, windmill to the front, right arm comes inside, left arm comes up, we counter the twist, breathe.
As you exhale, step back through Vinyasa or skip it and just meet me in downward facing dog. Hips in the air. All right, bring your feet together. We'll make it easier. Right leg in the air. Bring the right leg through. Arms come up overhead. Inhale.
Exhale, lean to your right side, bend the back knee. Straighten the back leg if you can. Inhale back to center. Exhale, hands to floor or block. Straighten your front leg. Square up your hips. Lengthen your spine.
And let it go. Inhale, turn your right toes to the left side of your mat. Lengthen your spine. Hands to your hips. Inhale all the way up.
Good. Arms out to the side. Left foot turns, warrior two, as you exhale. One pump. Inhale, arms and legs straighten. Exhale, hold. Good. Keep your left leg as it is. Right arm comes down, left arm comes up. Inhale, back to your warrior two. Exhale, straighten your front leg. Adjust the back leg if you need to for triangle pose. Reach out, 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 out. Left arm down, right arm up. And just put yourself against a wall behind you, right? Just imagine that your entire backside of your body is touching the wall. Legs are strong, knees are lifted, upper thighs rotate out, heels squeeze inward. One more breath. Good. Exhale, re-bend your front knee for warrior two. Make whatever adjustments you needed on that back leg. Inhale, windmill to the front of your mat, left arm down, right arm up. We twist. Breathe in, breathe out. Good. Empty the breath and step back through your plank. Chaturanga, up and downward facing dogs. So again, it's your choice if you want to take extra push-ups or none at all. Good. Inhale, left leg in the air. Open up your left hip, bend your knee. Let the heel just drop back towards the right hip. And keep your arms evenly carrying your weight. Chest towards your thighs, let your head hang nice and soft. And then inhale, turn your body forward, left knee to chest, rounding curl. And step the left foot through for your lunge. Come up for crescent lunge, arms up overhead. Lean to your left side, back knee bends or straightens, but keep it nice and low. Inhale to center and you exhale, hands to floor, left leg straightens and turns over to the right side. Halfway lift, inhale, hands to heart or hips as you rise up, exhale. Inhale, open arms out, warrior two, right leg. Inhale, pump your warrior. Exhale, stay in warrior two, reaching dynamically in two directions. Keep your right leg bent, left arm down, right arm up, side bend. Good. Inhale back through warrior two. Exhale, straighten your leg. Find your triangle pose. Inhale. Reach out and then reach down and up. Open up your side body. Lift up nice and strong in your quads. Listen carefully, guys. We're going flying. Bring your left hand to your left hip. Bend your right knee. Put your right hand on the floor. I'm going to turn myself forward so you can see. Right hand on the floor in front of or to the side or on a block of your right foot as you float your left leg off the floor. Spin your heart open. Stack your shoulders. Once you feel that you're there, left arm comes up and we're still, it's the same pose with our leg off the floor as triangle, right? So we're in our triangle pose with our leg off the floor. So we're still leaning ourselves against a wall. Inhale. And exhale. Any variations you take in this pose are welcome. So if you want to bind, if you want to lift your hands off the floor, think about pulling your left leg straight out away from you. One more breath. Now you can put your left hand on your hip or keep it up in the air. Bend your front knee enough to take you back to your triangle pose one more time. Inhale, come back up, warrior two, and reverse that warrior. Inhale back to warrior two as you exhale. And inhale, come on back to the front of your mat. Right hand down, left arm up, twist. Exhale, step back to plank, chaturanga, upward and downward facing dogs.
breathe in, breathe out. Inhale, right leg in the air. Bend your right knee. Keep your body, your upper body square. And let your right heel just kind of drop back towards your left hip. Just let gravity kind of open you up here. Inhale, right knee to your chest, round curl. And step it all the way through. High crescent lunge, arms up, inhale. Lean to your right side, exhale. Straighten the back leg, inhale, come up to standing. Exhale, hands down, right leg straightens, fold. Inhale, walk it over to your left side. Exhale, fold, and inhale, hands to hips, rise up to stand. Open up, warrior two, left leg bends. Exhale. Inhale, pump it once. Exhale, warrior two. Keep your left leg where it is, right arm down, left arm up. Inhale, back to warrior two. Exhale, straighten your legs, adjust if you need to. Move your hips to the right, torso to the left. Left arm down, right arm up. We are in triangle pose. Breathe in, breathe out. Good, one more breath as you bring your right hand to your hip. Soften your left knee. Bring your left hand to the front or side of your foot, and you come up slowly, perhaps lifting that right leg in the air, spinning it open, Ardha Chandrasana, half moon balance. Same pose as we were in with our feet on the floor, but now we have one foot off the floor. Perhaps you have two hands off the floor. There's many ways of skinning this little cat jumping over the moon. One more breath. Good, now bring your right hand down if you need to, but soften your left knee and make your way gracefully back into triangle pose. Left leg is straight, right leg is straight. Reaching up and down in opposition. Good. Inhale, come back through warrior two into a reverse warrior. Inhale, bend both knees, warrior two, as you exhale. And then inhale, windmill around to the front of your mat, right arm up. Left arm down. Exhale, step it through. High plank, low plank, you got the planks all the way up and down. Downward dog as you exhale, let's stay here for a bit. Not too long of a bit. Spiral your upper arms in, pull your chest towards your thigh, let your head hang down, shake it out, yes. Shake it out, no. Good, bring your feet a little closer to touch. Inhale, right leg high in the sky. Step it all the way through. Turn to your left side. Inhale, rise up. Bring your hands to your heart or hips and stand all the way up. Good. Take your left toes and turn them to the left. And then adjust your hips. We're going first back into triangle. So reach out in two directions. And then move your torso to the left and your hips to the right. Left arm down, right arm up. Keep that triangle. And from here, I want you to try to go into that balancing half moon. So bend your front knee and take flight with the right arm still up in the air, or maybe you've had to put it down. Flex the foot and open up, open up, open up. Any variations, if you're taking Shavasana, grab a hold of the foot. If you're taking a bind any other way or your hands to your heart center. Good, stay here. Settle in, take a few moments. And as you exhale, keep the arm up, soften the front knee, step back, triangle pose. Inhale up, reverse your warrior. Exhale, warrior two. Now spin around, bring your left hand down, right arm up. Option to stay right where you are, or step your right foot back and take it into side plank, Vashistasana, any variation. Breathe. Take the right arm perhaps over your head. Lift your side body up and in. Inhale. Exhale, one more breath. Right arm down, exhale through Chaturanga. Upward and downward facing dogs. Doing great, guys, hang in there. Nice job. Feet together. Inhale, left leg nice and high in the sky. step it on through. Turn over to your right side, your right into your side, into your wide-legged Paschimottanasana. Inhale, halfway lift, hands to your hips or apart. Good, turn the right toes out, keep the legs straight this time for triangle pose. Move your hips left, move your torso right. Right arm down, left arm up. Open up your heart, stack your shoulders. Lift everything up, pull your knees up, squeeze your heels towards each other. Now, look down at your right foot, bend the knee as much as you need to, put your hand in front or to the side, and begin to float up into Ardha Shavasana. And then play any variations you have that you'd like to stay with or play with. Inhale, lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Exhale, hug everything towards your midline, nice and strong on that left leg. One more big, beautiful, happy breath. Exhale, keep the arm up if you'd like. Bend your front knee enough to get you back into your triangle pose. Inhale, reverse your warrior, bend the right leg, left arm down. Inhale, back to warrior two. And exhale, windmill down, right hand down, left arm up, twist, stay here, or slide back into Vashistasana. A couple times it took me today, I don't know why. And lift your hip up, arm overhead perhaps. Find a little bit opening here. Just keep lifting, lifting, lifting. And now as you exhale, that hand comes down right into your chaturanga, or skip it, upward and downward facing dogs. Breathe in and out. Soften your knees. Walk your feet. You can come halfway up your mat here. Walk your hands back to your feet, halfway lift or on blocks. Exhale, fold over. Inhale, ragdoll to stand all the way up. Bring your arms up over your head. Bring your feet together. Bring your hands to your heart center. Settle in for a moment. Close your eyes. And then bring your arms down by your side. Good. Open your eyes. Bring your weight into your left leg and lift your right knee up. Hold it. And then without using your arms, open the knee out to the side. And then hug the left hip in towards midline. And then if you need a help, your hand will help guide your foot into tree pose. Hug your hip and inner thigh, or your foot and inner thigh together. Bring your hands to your heart center. Keep pulling that left hip inward and outward. Take another breath. You can change your arms, right? You can take them up. You can do anything that you want to, or still keep them in prayer, because it's fine. We're concerned about pulling that left hip towards your midline. Nice, Karen. Good, guys. There you go. If your hands are up in the air, go ahead, bring them back to prayer. And then if you need to assist your hand, take your right ankle above your left knee, and then come back to your prayer. Good. Stay here, or begin to just bend your knee. If you want to go any further, you can take it into a flying pigeon, or any variations. Or single legs, crow. I don't remember the Sanskrit name to this. I always forget. So if your hands are on the floor block and you want to fly, your right foot just kind of hugs around your left tricep, and you plant your hands down and you come down and send yourself into flight. And if you're just working on the hip stretch, stay where you're at. This is perfect. Now if you are towards the floor with your hands, see if you can come back up to standing. Bring your hands to your heart. Straighten your left leg and bring your right knee into your chest. Extend your right leg out, arms up. Right leg to the floor. Bend your knees for chair. Oh, look, our first chair of the day. Inhale. Exhale, fold over your legs and fold. Actually, we did a half chair, so we're good. Ragdoll to stand all the way up. Take your time. Arms overhead. Exhale, hands to prayer. Send your weight to your right leg. Lift your left leg up. Balance. Try to keep the knee in line with the hip, maybe a little higher. Flex the foot. Open it out to the side without changing anything else about your body. And then maybe help it out. Bring the foot into the inner thigh. Vrikshasana tree pose. Pull your right hip in. And then squeeze your inner thigh and foot together nice and strong. Crown of the head nice and tall. Inhale and exhale.
Any variations you're doing with your arms, whatever you did on the other side, feel free to take again. And then go ahead and cross left ankle above right knee. Welcome back. I guess maybe you got cut off.
So sorry.
Welcome back. We're standing with our left ankle across our right knee. So any variation here, you can stay upright, you can bend your knees, you can fly. If you need your hands on blocks or floor, breathe in, breathe out. So you might notice that one hip is tighter than the other, as you might even see on me. Breathe in, breathe out. Good, if you're anywhere but standing, bring your hands back to your heart, come up to standing, and then bring your hands or your leg, oops, into your chest. Extend the arms and legs and lower the foot to the floor. Bend your knees, chair pose. Inhale, fold down, let your head come down, straighten your legs. Chin to your chest, roll through your spine, come on up. Arms all the way up overhead. Exhale, hands to prayer. All right, bring your hands to your hips. Without, bye Rach, love you. Send your weight to your left leg, right leg up. Good. Take your right hand, big toe, or hold on to your knee. If you're holding on to the toe, perhaps you want to straighten your leg to the best of your ability. And then float your left arm up over your shoulder. Good. Switch arms. Whoops, dancing Shiva. Reach your right arm back. Reach, reach, reach. Maybe your eye gaze goes back, and that will be the last thing that you do, and it'll challenge your balance the most. Breathe in, breathe out. Closing off those hips we opened so much. Come back to center slowly. Let go of your right leg. Hold it there for 3, 2, feet together, knees bent, chair. Take your elbows, hands in prayer, left elbow outside, right knee twist. Check out your left knee, make sure it's not shooting forward, drop your seat down, lift your belly up, turn to your right side and breathe. One more breath. And exhale, hands to floor. Straighten your legs, fold. Chin to chest, let's rag up. Bring your arms with you overhead. Inhale, prayer to your heart center as you exhale. Hands on your hips. This also helps you to feel the levelness of your hips, right? You're not leaning off to one side more than the other. Now just bend your left knee, put your weight in your right leg. You can hold on with your hand. You can hold on to your big toe grip. And you can extend the leg. So whatever is working for you, then the right arm comes up. Take your time, switch arms. Left arm back, right arm forward. Turning your chest to the left side, maybe your eye gaze to your left hand. Breathe in, breathe out. My leg is not straight, so the leg doesn't have to be straight, right? It's not about straightening the leg. We're trying to make that rotation. Breathe. Lori, is your leg all the way up? Holy moly. Good, now, if you're in that rotated dancing Shiva, come back to center, arms up, hold the leg up for 3, 2, 1, bring the foot to the floor, bend your knees, chair, and then take a chair, twist to the outside of the left leg, and check out your right knee, make sure it's not shooting forward, drop your seat back and down, lift your heart, inhaling and exhaling. One more big breath. As you empty the breath, fold over your legs, let it go. Separate your feet hips width apart. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Take your peace finger grip around your big toes. Wrap your thumbs underneath your fingers, between your fingers and toes. Look forward. And then hook your arms out to the side as your head comes down towards your shins.
Send your weight a little bit forward towards the bottoms of your feet, or the balls of your feet and the toes. One more breath. Inhale, lengthen. Release your hands to the floor. Exhale, fold. Inhale, roll to stand. Bring the arms with you overhead. Arms up, feet together, hands to your heart, arms by your side. So if you're not at the front of your mat, take a step or two forward. Inhale, bring the arms overhead. Exhale, fold your hands to floor, shins or blocks. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, step or jump back, lower down through vinyasa, come through chaturanga or skip it or add to it, lift your heart. And downward facing dog is where we meet. Good, high up on your tippy toes. Lift your right leg in the air. Good, bring your right knee to your chest, come forward to high plank. And then slide your right knee to your right wrist. Left toes come back behind you. Snuggle it back, come up onto your fingertips first. Take your hands outside of your mat, and then just fold, rolling, little undulating push-ups here for three. Two more. Good, let your body kind of flow with it. One more. Good, and as soon as you've completed that one, make your way into your full pigeon pose for you, right? Whatever works for you. You want to bring your hip on a block. Maybe you need to be on your back. So many of us do. So feel free to go on your back, cross your right ankle, which we just did on the floor standing. You can cross your right ankle above your left knee. If you'd like, you can put your head all the way down. Just keep your hips squared rather than rolling off onto that right hip. And that's where the block sometimes comes in handy. Breathe in and out. Inhale. And exhale. Softening the neck, softening the breath, softening the gaze, and slowing down. Inhale, walk your hands back in. Lift yourself up. If you're on a block, you may take it out and sweep your left leg out to the side. So if you're on your back, you can just come back to sitting, bring the right leg crossed in, left leg out to the side. And then take your left hand and reach it. Maybe you reach your toe grip. Take your right arm up and over to the side. Look under your right arm as we did way back in the beginning when we were doing our side bending here. Reaching over to your left side, but pushing your right hip down. Good, inhale, come back up, right hand down behind your hips, and just open up and push your hips into that dancer's bridge. Exhale, come down to the floor. Take your left leg and sweep it on the outside of your right. Left hand behind you, right arm up. Take a hug, twist, or a bind outside your left thigh. Look up, inhale. Exhale, twist deeper. And one more breath. Exhale, look right, and then fold right. Let it go. Inhale, back to center. Sweep your left leg behind you. Tuck the toes, hands on the floor. Lift your right shin off the floor. Hold it for a moment. And then take it all the way up and open. Right hip on top of left. Bend the knee just like we did earlier. But now, if you want to, take your foot over behind you. Flip your dog or dancer's bridge. Lift your heart up. Exhale, rewind. Right leg in the air. Same dog, right knee to the chest, round curl, and then step your foot down, downward facing dog, take an optional vinyasa. Well, you know they're all optional, right? But one here would be nice if you want to take it and clear the slate. Feet are together at the back of your mat. Inhale, your left leg in the air, open the hip, bend the knee. Just hold it there or play with it, explore it. Exhale, turn your knee to your chest, round curl. This time you come
So again, you might be on a block, you might be on your back. You're here, hands outside your thighs, or your mat, three undulating push-ups. One more. And then make your way into your pigeon, your favorite place to be in this pose. Again, it could be on your back with your left ankle crossed above your right knee, as we just did standing. And then see if you can settle down through your center a little bit more. Think about your hip points pointing to the floor. So if you're off on your left leg, your right hip point is going to point off a little bit, not to the floor, to the side.
And just stay here and breathe.
Take a couple more breaths here. Inhale, bring your hands back. If you have a block, slide it out for a moment, and then come down onto your left hip. Right leg comes out to the side. Square off your shoulders. And then walk your right hand down your right leg. Maybe you grab a hold of the toe. Maybe it's not as accessible as it was on the other side. Feel free to use straps or towels. Left arm up and over. Look under your left arm. Keep rounding your left hip. Breathe in, breathe out. Find peace here. Inhale up, left arm down, right arm up. Sweep it open. Get a nice release in that hip. Exhale, hips down. Right leg comes all the way over the left. If you need to, you straighten the bottom leg out. Hug, twist, or bind to your right side. Make sure you're not sitting on your left heel, but your hips are connecting to the earth. Oh, and you should hear the snap, crackle, pop that just went on in my spine. Inhale and exhale, twist. Keep tall through your spine. Keep long. Use your back hand to create that length. And use your other hand, your left arm, to twist and get a little deeper. One more breath. Keep your twist, but look to the left. And then release to the left. Come back to center. Sweep your right leg behind you. Tuck the toes underneath you, hands under shoulders. And just let your left leg come up and hover off the floor. Bring it back up in the air, three-legged dog. Open your left hip on top of your right, and this time if you want to flip your dog, take it over. You can be in a back bend, or you can be in a dancer's bridge, or you can just play with it and maybe go to plank. Exhale, rewind, left leg up, left knee to your chest, round a curl, downward facing dog. Inhale on your toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of your mat. And then walk, step, jump, float, hop, fly, slide through. Come into a seated position. Take yourself a little bit closer to the front of your mat so that you, when you come down, your head is on the mat, not on the floor. Sit up nice and tall, holding on underneath your thighs. Just going to change my angle for you guys. Sit up tall. Exhale, drop your chin to your chest, and then round your spine like you got punched in the stomach. Relax your shoulders and neck. Good. Keep holding onto your legs. Scoop out your belly so you're really starting to lower down. I want you to get down onto your waistline, or to your waistline, and bring your feet a little bit closer together, or closer to your heels, your hips. Boy, good thing I really talk well today, huh? Bring your hands behind your head just to support your head. Nothing changed between here and here with my neck. All right, I have space between my chin and collarbone for my fist, and that's where I'm staying. Breathe in. Breathe out. Lift your right leg up off the floor. Inhale. Exhale. Maybe you can come a little higher with your torso. Inhale. Right leg comes down as you exhale. Left leg comes up. Inhale. Higher.
Inhale, exhale, left leg down. Now inhale, both legs up, 90 degrees at your hip and knees. Lift up, 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 a little bit higher in your torso if you have it. One more breath, take it a little higher. And as you exhale, lower your head to the floor. Hug your knees all the way to your chest. Take a happy baby with your feet towards the ceiling. Holding onto peace finger grip or your outer foot or perhaps underneath your knees. And rock a little side to side just to kind of massage out our spine. Good. Take your hands on the outside of the legs and hug your knees into your chest. Let's do one bridge or wheel. So take your feet to the floor. See where you're at if you're ready to go into a wheel. Hold on to your ankles or your shins. Tilt your tailbone or tilt your pelvis. The tailbone tucks under. Lift your hips up off the floor. We'll all start in a bridge. You can be on a supported bridge with a block or your hands at your back. Or if you're ready and want to go into your final big, beautiful back bend, put your hands by your shoulders. Elbows point up, head to the floor slowly, lift up into your biggest and brightest back bend of the morning, perhaps of the day, maybe of the weekend. Hopefully not. You can come join us again tomorrow. As you come down when you're ready, tuck your chin, top of the head, upper mid, lower back to the floor. And then hug your knees into your chest. Once again, rock on your spine. Maybe make circles on your spine. Go in one direction and then the other. And then hug your knees all the way close, really, really tight. Get as close as you can. Lift your head and shoulders and tuck your head to your knees. Lower your head, open your arms, but keep the knees nice and close. As you shift your hips right, let your knees fall to the left. Big spinal twist. Reaching out from your center point. If you have the space and desire, stretch your legs out straight. Feel free. Inhale to center. Take everything close again. Hug your knees in really tight. Everything squeezes in. Head and shoulders lift up, up, up. Inhale. And as you exhale, keep the head, keep the legs close as you open the arms, head down. Hips shift left, knees fall to the right. And then if you did so on the other side, feel free to straighten your legs. Slowly make your way back to center. Hug your knees back to your chest. This time you can have a little bit of give. Rock on your spine. And then let your legs come out in front of you. Let your arms stretch over your head. Reach from your center point once again. Right side long, left side long. Arms and legs away from midline. Belly and ribs to hips. Take a big breath. And when you exhale the breath, bring your arms by your side, palms facing up. Let your body surrender. Settle into your final shavasana, this final pose of your yoga practice. Often said to be the hardest pose because there is nothing to do. Let your body completely melt into the earth. Notice the rise and fall of the chest and the abdomen. Let it be like a massage to your body.
have the time to stay in your shavasana, feel free to stay, just shut me off. But if you need to come back to Saturday morning, start to deepen your breath, move your fingers, your toes, your wrists, your ankles. Yeah, and then make your way onto either side. Slowly and carefully on your own time, make your way to a comfortable seat. Bring your hands to your heart. First, for a moment of gratitude to yourselves for making it to yoga this morning, for staying there, for doing just what you needed to do on your mat. Om Shanti, 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 Om Peace, Peace, Peace to all. Now let's all bow down, honor the light, the good, and the peace within each one of us. Namaste, Sat Nam, go in peace. Have a wonderful Saturday, or weekend, or day till I see you. Stay home, stay fit, stay healthy.